Stephen Tau het met ontleeders gesels oor wat die verkiesingsuitslag vir die ANC kan beteken.
Soos die uitslag deur die loop van vandag deurgekom het, het die prentjie duideliker geraak. Daar is nie goeie nuus vir die ANC nie. Wat beteken die swak uitslag vir die eens magtige party?
Dit sal 'n geskiedkundige oomblik wees wanneer die ANC vir die eerste keer in 'n verkiesing minder as 50% van die stemme kry. Na verwagting is dit presies wat gaan gebeur wanneer die OVK hulle finale uitslag binnekort bekend maak. Die politieke ontleder Sanusha Naidu sê die uitslag behoort niemand te verbas nie.
For the ruling party, they make stupid statements, if I may be as bold as that. You know, we will rule until Jesus comes. I mean, what does that mean? That Jesus has been in so many metros now, in so many forms, and in so many creations and incarnations and whatever, that you can't talk in these rhetorical statements. You know, I think that makes the electorate frustrated at this thing. So I think for the ruling party going forward, and I know it's the usual rhetoric of consolidation, thinking about it, but I think the problem is they're going to have, well, not the problem, but the dilemma they already face is what will this mean when Ramaphosa goes back to the next NEC meeting? What will be the accountability that will happen? Will this give his opponents more information to disarm him?
Naidu meen baie politici besef nog nie regtig watter belangrike skuiwe die afgelope paar dae plaasgevind het nie.
They're more worried about the numbers and how we can get control. They're not worried about the fact that 14 million people didn't think they deserved their vote. And includes the ANC. So we have to be careful in celebrating mediocrity.
Professor Lisiba Tefu, 'n politieke ontleder verbonde aan UNISA, sê die ANC moet nou selfondersoek instel.
I think it serves them well. And many within the ANC will also concede that it is the right thing to happen to them at this juncture. For good men and women, men and women of integrity have been repulsed by the stench of corruption that has become so synonymous with the ruling party. Let them taste what it is to lose power. Then they will be humbled and perhaps even be magnanimous enough to say, you know what? Yes, we didn't listen when advised. And this is the price we are paying. Which price, in my own humble opinion, is in the best interest of the country. Even mediocres, men and women of no integrity or worth, people not fit for purpose, found themselves in executive positions, found themselves presiding over state institutions, state enterprises, and they all collapsed.